All right, so now we're live, and they said it wouldn't be done, but it is, and we are cosplaying. This is the first Cosplay Coffee Run, and I had to take this off because obviously I'm not going to drive with this on since all I see is yellow right now. But yeah, this is, I'm your friendly neighborhood host, Spider-Man, and this is Sam, Mr. Sanchez, and or actually what he's cosplaying right now is Gilbert.
Yeah, Gilbert, so. Nitrate from Pandora Hearts.
Yeah, so you can call him, refer to him as that. Let me make sure. This is all, yeah, that's good.
You can call me Sam or Gil for sure. I don't mind.
Right. Either one. Either one's good. So yeah, this is a this is the first cosplay coffee run, which is, I think it's going to work out pretty well so far. I've been in this costume for like half the day. Well, not really, but still. Actually, I think it has been half the day so far as when I woke up, but still.
Yeah.
But yeah, so we're just going to get coffee. And then, and before anyone asks, why would Spider-Man be getting coffee instead of web-slinging to get coffee? And I'm just going to say because he has a guest with him, and he doesn't want to carry his guest with his webs. I mean, that would be a good, like, romance thing to do, but not for today.
Yeah, we can't do that on camera.
Right? But yeah, that's there's been a lot of people checking out this house lately because it's been on sale.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, and they like to pull in my driveway. I don't know why they hate when people do that, because everybody always goes on the street and they do that. But yeah.
It's always the worst whenever, like, someone parks in front of your own driveway, and then when you try to get in, they look at you like, you're the idiot.
Yeah, and it's happened a lot before with my house. I don't know why. But I mean, I don't know, aside from that, what have you been, how has your life been lately? Because I haven't, we haven't caught up with, let's see, it's been a while.
Yeah, like, honestly, it was Barbella.
Yeah,
no, it wasn't Barbella, it was when you brought Spencer, right?
Oh, yeah, that was a little after it, I think. Like,
yeah.
Like, it was either in late May or early June. I think it was late May, though. Like,
yeah, I think it was late May.
Oh, yeah, because remember it was when Papa's was closing down.
Yeah, exactly.
I remember that now.
That's, you know, how long ago. Like for us, man, when we closed down our restaurant, we made that transition. Mm-hmm. Those first 2 weeks were, like, the worst 2 weeks, like, I ever had working at Papa's. It was, like, we consistently would always beat the Mother's Day we had at the original restaurant. So you can imagine having Mother's Day every day for 2 weeks was, man, it was stressful.
I gotta make sure I brought. Okay, good. I was just making sure I had my wallet, because I was about to say, if I forgot that, I'd be screwed. Because sometimes I actually have forgotten it, but very rarely does that happen.
Either way, I'd spot you anyway.
Yeah, but, yeah, I mean, that's cool. So, like, you're still, did you make the transfer, I guess, to, because you're at Papa's, right? And then now you're.
Yeah, it's Papado's now. We're at Papado's now. And, I mean, it's all good. I mean, the restaurant looks really nice. Like, from what they did to it, it looks really nice. The kitchen's a lot bigger, and we have a lot more people working. Granted, it's like, you know, it's still the same old stuff, same old bullcrap, but.
Yeah, sucks to hear that, but it looks, I mean, I went there once with the family. It looks really nice in there, like, the bar area is.
The bar is really nice.
Yeah, they did a good job. I mean, just the whole thing, they actually did a pretty good job. I thought we weren't going to find parking there, but luckily we did. I mean, because it's always packed there now. Like,
yeah, it's been like that for a while now. The thing that one of our selling points at our place, I guess, is that now you'll notice on the marquee, like, hey, the Texans are playing and we're on the patio, come on in. Like, they played yesterday, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was insane in the bar last night.
I could imagine. That's crazy. Like, but I think, we lost, so I shouldn't have to say that in camera, but yeah, we did.
Hey, man.
It happens. But still want, you know.
Yeah, man. He defensive player, and he scored, what, 3 touchdowns already?
Yeah, he's freaking good. And, I mean, like, he's, like, he literally is the face of the Texans, it seems. He might as well be. But, I mean, then again, he deserves all the credit he gets. He's a really great player.
That's true. That's
and
very
he,
true.
He's a great HEB spokesperson.
Yeah.
Because he
always
He really, see, and I was telling my friend, I think I told Angie, I was like, man, if I could, I would totally be, like, a spokesperson for Waterbury, because I love their stuff. Like, everybody always knows I love, I post about taquitos and then their burgers and.
The A1 Thick and Hearty is,
that,
like,
one's good.
Man, that's, like, that one's true to my heart, man. That one's
really good. Because they always have those 4 special burgers.
Yes,
right?
Like, that's the one thing that always gets me going back to Whataburger. I love Whataburger's burgers and chicken, like, period. Everything about them is good. But those things, like, for me, is just like, oh, man. Yeah, after saying that now, I'm getting hungry, man.
Yeah.
I'm all spitting out saliva at this point trying to talk.
Yeah, I know. Well, if you get hungry enough, we can go to Whataburger. I mean, I already ate, but I don't mind stopping there if you need something to eat. Because, I mean, that's... I was there this morning because I got some taquitos for breakfast.
Oh, nice.
I love their taquitos. They're just... Because I get the sausage one, and then they... Like, I always have them add bacon because I just have to have bacon with something. So...
Yeah. With, no, like, bacon with everything, man. Like...
Mm-hmm. Like the epic meal times.
Yes, you know, bacon like grease and your bacon grease and the Jack Daniel shots. Oh yeah, man.
That's hilarious. But yeah, that's pretty cool. So you've mainly just been like working. What about school? You've been...
Yeah, I've been going to school as well. And when I was doing summer school, it was not fun. Because, like whenever you're working like 55, 60 hours a week plus, and then you're going to school during the summer, it was murder. Mm-hmm. I remember the one day I walked into work, and my manager saw me, and I had like these bags under my eyes. My eyes were bloodshot. Yeah. He's like, man, we're cutting your hours, dude. Like, you look like crap.
Yeah,
and I was like, all right, cool, you know. But yeah, I mean, right now it's been all right. I mean, I'm still, right now I'm at University of Houston downtown trying to get my degree in business administration.
Nice.
What am I gonna do with that? I have no clue. But
nobody has an idea what they're gonna do with their degrees. They just think they do. Trust me, I don't, because everybody goes to college, they just go to get a degree, but yeah, they don't know what they're gonna do after it, and that's okay, because at least you're getting something, you know. That's it's good you're going for.
Yeah.
So especially business administration, that's really good.
Yeah. My teacher told me the same thing. He's like, you know, I've had plenty of students like get their degrees and like they'll turn 45 and they're like, okay, now I know what I want to do with my life. So you know. All right, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I have a few friends that have been through that too. But I mean, it's like I said, sometimes it just takes a while to find what you want to do, and when you find it, you there's something about you just hold on to and you just keep wanting to do it. So as with me with because I'm going to a lot in the fall. I'm going to U of H Maine, taking two classes there. Well, one is online, but I'm taking one in person there, and then I'm going to San Jac Central and going for that audio engineering certificate. So I'm taking audio engineering one there.
Yeah,
which is really fun. So, and I hate to, it sucks because I've for the past year I've been feeling torn between psychology and music, because I want to do both so bad.
Yeah, I understand that, man.
And I hate that, but so I'm trying to make it work, and I am going to make it work. Like eventually, somehow it's going to happen. But I'm going for my bachelor's still, you know, my bachelor of arts, I think, because I'm still debating on whether I want to do arts or science. I might just do arts though, because that's already what I declared anyway from the start. So
right,
but doing bachelor of arts and psychology at U of H, and then I'm going for the certificate in audio engineering here at San Jac. But I'm thinking after I get my bachelor's at U of H, I kind of want to go for like an associate's in just, you know, audio engineering or something with production, you know, like music production. I really want to get into that, and I'm finally starting to learn that now, like kind of like how to use Pro Tools, and because that's what they have us working on is Pro Tools, the HDX or the HD system, because there's an HDX system, but they're making us use the HD one.
Oh,
but
okay.
It's really cool to finally learn how like hook up because they have us use the mixing boards, like the sound boards, like
there's
the Soundcraft, and then there's like Dallin Heath, and it's so cool to kind of like, I've always thought it was hard to use those things, because I was like, how do they have so many knobs and all this shit, and I'm like, I don't know how the hell people would, like a lot of people like me, when they first see it, they're going to say, I have no idea like how I would even figure this out, but when you get down to it, it's really just, you know, these are for auxiliary, these are for, you know, effects, this is for, you just pan this left or right to, you know, like I now know how to comfortably hook up a microphone and have it send it to the speakers and the monitors, and like, it's just really cool to finally know how to do all that. Like, I went to Guitar Center on Saturday.
Right.
I went on Saturday and I saw the same Soundcraft mixing board that I saw, that we have in our class that I wanted. It was like $3,500 though, but yeah, it's really nice. Like, I knew, I was messing around with it, and I was telling my friend Mike, I was like, look, dude, this is so cool because I finally know how to do all this now. Like, this is where you put the microphone, and you just got to pan it. I was like, okay, where's the mic? And I was actually looking for a microphone in the store like, just to hook it up, but it's cool because that's when, I think that's when you know you love what you're doing, is when you just get excited about doing whatever it is that's in front of you that you have, that you like, and that's what's really cool. And I think, you know, I don't know, I just like, and I still love psychology too because that's interesting, but there's just always two sides to one story, I guess.
Yeah.
All right, what are you going to want, good sir?
Thank you for choosing Starbucks. This is Kim. How can I help you today?
I'll take a grande caramel frappe.
Grande caramel frappuccino. What else can I do for you?
And let me also, give me 1 minute.
Sure, take your time. Let us know if you have any questions.
Mm-hmm. Let me go ahead and do the caramel macchiato, grande.
Let's see. I'll have a grande caramel macchiato.
Okay.
And that should be it.
So grande caramel frappuccino.
Yep.
Alright, go ahead and report it.
Alright, thank you. They're gonna freak out because they're gonna be like, what the hell is Spider-Man doing here?
And it's like, who's this guy over there? And it's like, oh, okay.
That's gonna be funny though.
But if you actually do it with the mask, it'd just be like, hey.
I was thinking of it, but knowing me, I'm probably gonna drop my damn thing with like the coffee. I don't wanna do that. But that's gonna be, I would do it though. They're gonna be, because then they'll probably think that we're getting robbed or something. They're gonna be like, oh my god, he's trying to rob us. Because this is connected to a chase after all. So. Yeah. That would be funny. Local bank gets robbed by Spider-Man. That'd be pretty fun. Hey, is that my friend? I think that is my friend. Yeah, I know her.
Okay.
So she'll know me.
All right.
Screw yeah. it. I might as well. I'm going to wait until... Here, I'll wait till this car moves up and then I'll put it on.
All right.
She's going to be like, what the hell are you doing here like this? And what's funny is this isn't going to be the only... Hopefully this isn't going to be the only cosplay coffee run I do.
Yeah. So,
there it is. Is it on right? I'm hoping it's on right. I honestly can't believe I'm doing this. They're going to be like, oh, hey.
Hell yeah, Spidey.
Let me see if this is on right. I'm going to take it off when I get up there. I'm just going to see what they say.
Yeah.
They're going to be like, what the hell?
Hi, friendly neighborhood Spider-Man.
Yeah, and it does get hot in this after a while. Like, oh. At Matsuri, I was... I think after the first half hour, I was like sweating bullets because it was a lot of people there Saturday because like, on Saturday's like the most packed.
And the convention rooms are like so hot too because of all the bodies that are moving around. All
right, let's see what happens here. This is gonna be hilarious.
Hello.
Hey.
What's up?
How are you?
I'm very
good.
Yeah.
All right, let me go ahead and get. All right, let's see. I got this one. Actually, let me use the other one. I know, I'm glad. I was hoping y'all wouldn't think I was robbing y'all. Even though I should get free coffee.
Yeah,
really?
Yeah, somebody robbed the lady outside.
Oh, wow.
They stabbed the pole.
That's horrible. Yeah. Horrible. Let me see. Are there two straws?
Weren't you supposed to be on patrol, man?
I know. My Spidey sense. I was at work getting things for Jameson. Pictures for Did you need napkins?
Oh, that guy.
Somebody loaded with your car.
Yeah, I know. It's my coworker. You're a student. Did you need any napkins?
I'll take them.
You can put them on the side if you need to. Thank you. That's hilarious. Let me make sure. Ooh, this is kind of warm. This is funny. This is a success for the first cosplay coffee run.
Yeah.
I'll put this in here real fast. Sorry.
Yeah, already
thank you.
Have a great day.
All right, you too. I love these. I guess I don't know which one's which.
This one is
wrap. Like the straw. Did you want to just here? You can have. Oh, did you need a straw?
Mm-mm.
All right, cool.
No, this is good the way it is.
All right, and then we'll just like I usually do, just drive around and abduct people for the comfort run.
Yeah. And just like you, over here.
Man, I can't wait for other people to cosplay with me. I'm hoping I can get my friend James in here, or Awesome James as they.
Oh yeah.
As I like to refer to him as. But yeah, that'd be hilarious. I wonder if anybody's seen me in here, like as. And the costume, because that'd be pretty funny. They're gonna be like, oh, look,
that's
weird. Yeah, usually this is like the classic coffee run driving route is just going this way and driving. I wish that light were turned green already, so because I hate holding up this
like
guy.
Lane, like, lane. That one guy, you gotta take up the two lanes.
Right. But I hate being that guy, but sorry, thank you. It's a fellow Camaro driver, so he's cool. I think he gets me.
Yeah.
And I needed one of these because I was actually pretty tired this morning. Well, I don't know. Like, I had, like, that rush of tiredness because I thought I got enough sleep, but I didn't.
Like, for me, I only got, like, maybe, like, what time did I fall asleep last night? Man, it was, like, maybe, like, 4:35 when I fell asleep. And then I got up at 8.
You're more of a night owl than me.
Yeah. And, like, when I got up, I was, like, in the back of my mind, I was, like, I know if I wake up and I stay in bed and try to say 5 more minutes, I'm going to wake up at, like, 1 or 2 in the afternoon. I'm going to miss this whole thing. Mm-hmm. And I was like, no, you know what? I'm going to get up, make me some coffee. And then, you know what? After that, I was just, like, I was just burning, turning and burning, going out.
Yeah. Coffee for the win, too.
Yeah.
I think, yeah, coffee's helped me out of a lot of tough spots this year, especially with the freaking, the lack of sleep I've been getting. Because for the past month now, I've been working 10 hours a day, so that's what, 3 p.m. to, I usually get off at 11:30, but lately it's been 3 p.m. to 1:30 a.m., and then I go, and that's been Monday through Friday, and then I have class Monday through Thursday, so I have to get up at least by 9 because I have class at 10. So I've been averaging maybe like 5 to 6 hours of sleep at the most.
That's not too bad. I think I'll be
okay. I don't have any damn change.
I'll give her a moment.
Yeah. I saw her out here.
Yeah.
The other day, that sucks. All right, let me. Yeah, that sucks. At least it's not one of those, you know, like, people that are, like, always on the corner with the, like, religion thingies, and they're always trying to, like, because I've given them money before, then I see them, like, migrate to another spot.
Yeah, and I've seen that.
They're, like, schemers that way, but this girl, I feel bad for.
Yeah, and I know when people have their own situations, it's like, yeah, you want to help them out. Typically, whenever I pass up a person, I try to give them what I can, you know. It's not even so much that, like, I'm not guilted into doing it, but, like, I'm more, like, thrown into, like, you know, I must do this. Like, it's like...
Me, it's kind of just the guilt thing. I feel, you know, bad. And then they see me in, like, Soundwave, and I'm like, oh, crap, I have to do something. I don't know. But still, I should have just, you know, been like, I should have just given her a hug. That's what they should get, is just hugs or whatever. My friend, I remember from our city, he wore a sign that just said free hugs.
Yeah. Oh, man. You gotta look now. I'm not a fan of the people that walk around with the yaoi and the yaoi paddles and just like, yeah, you know, come over here. Right. I got a surprise for you.
That's now, a little too much.
Yeah, now and it's worse when it's a girl. Mm. Because the thing is that the guys, they swing hard, but, you know, they're like, oh, you're a dude.
They know when to stop.
Yeah, they know when to stop. With the girls, though, they're all like...
They love that shit.
Oh, man, they like... You could see them, like, to them, it's like they can write their own 50 Shades of Grey with, like, with a paddle in their hand.
I know. That's hilarious.
Only it's the reverse. It's the reverse.
That's hilarious.
Don't get any ideas, by the way.
But, yeah, that's, I guess back to the music until we sidetracked with the whole thing, the anime one. So, well, speaking of my studio, are you going to be going next year?
I am going to be going. The only thing is... There's two. The other one I want to go to, and I'm definitely going to go to San Japan and take my best friend with me.
I've been wanting to go to that. I just haven't been able to because that's in San Antonio, right?
Yeah, it's in San Antonio. Yeah, it's awesome in San Antonio. It really is.
Yeah, I hear it's really good. My friend's been wanting to go again because I think he's went like a few times already, but I haven't been able to go, and I really want to because I hear like that's one of the best ones. I mean, my city's gotten really big though too. Like I think over the past.
Oh yeah!
Few years.
Oh man! Most definitely.
I went to the one in 2013 and this year, and this year was by far, like, the biggest yet, it looked like, because, I mean, it's gotten really crazy, and then, like, especially with Attack on Titan now, with how
massive
that's been getting, like, it's crazy how, when I went there this year, there was so many people dressed as, you know, like, the Scout Regiment, and then there was, like some people, like, a lot of people dressed as Titans, or no, I think there was one guy who was brave enough to dress as a Titan and just have his, you know... His unmentionables covered up. But yeah, it was really like I give that guy props. That guy had some balls.
Yeah.
Because he was freaking, you know, the whole convention I saw him just walk around pretty much almost butt ass naked with as a Titan. I thought that was pretty good. And I didn't know how I didn't watch the show back like I wasn't really fully into the show back then, so I didn't know what the hell he was, but I knew he was a Titan. I was like, man, that's crazy. And now it's like, man, that show's been, like, widely accepted as, like, the leading show lately, it seems like.
Yeah.
And I mean, it's on Toonami now, in English, too.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah, that's the thing, is, like, you know when, like, it comes to America quickly, it's, mm-hmm. They're doing something right.
Yeah, and then, like, I know people have been going crazy, because I never got a chance to get into it. Like, well, I did, at the very beginning, but I haven't been able to keep up with it, but, a lot of people are going crazy because of Naruto. It's finally ending.
Yeah,
like,
and they're like, and just to some people, on our side, it's like, thank God. And
right.
I'm like, man, it's like, y'all guys been dragging this out way too long.
Yeah, well, they say it's the manga that's ending, right?
Or yeah.
Is it the
it's the manga that's ending.
Yeah, because the anime is still, of course, a little bit behind, I think, right?
It's yeah.
Still trying to, but yeah, that's, I just know that everybody's going crazy right now because, you know, what's going to happen in the manga or whatever about, like, Naruto and Sasuke or whatever.
Yeah.
So, like, I know everybody's going crazy over that, but yeah, it's insane. But I really, my studio, I definitely plan on going to. I mean, speaking of events like that, like, are there any shows you plan on going to, like, this year as far as music-wise?
Once again, I wanted to go to something wicked, but work just doesn't like me. Like, work does not like me having my days off. The only thing I am going to, and because I have to do some volunteer work tomorrow for the Houston Food Bank, is after I'm done volunteering there, there's going to be an event called Untapped. That's going to be in Discovery Green. Nice. And what it is going to have like 200 different types of beers and like breweries that bring their own beer.
Wow.
And they're going to have food and concerts there. And I didn't get to see the venue or the lineup, but you know, I love alcohol.
And it's free too.
Yeah.
That's cool. Yeah, that's going to be pretty fun. Yeah, this year, I mean, I'm excited because, well, let's see, this year I went to, January, I don't think I went to anything. April, I went to Foster the People, I remember.
Okay.
Yeah, I saw them. I met them, actually, too, after the show. And I got their autograph, and it was because me and Angie both, like, went back there and, like, waited. And I felt like a rapist because there were so many little kids there. And I'm like, oh, God, there's, like, so many little hipster kids. I was like, why? They're too young for this, but...
Well, that's their fault then, right?
Yeah, but anyway, like, I saw them, and then May, of course, was Free Press.
Oh, yeah.
August, I saw Feed Me. I almost was about to go see Little Dragon, too, but I didn't have any money at the time to buy the ticket. I really wanted to go, but yeah, I saw Feed Me. And then 4 days after Feed Me, I went to my very first reggae show, like, reggae concert.
Oh, wow, man.
Yeah, and my friend Micah brought me along. He gave me a free ticket or whatever. Because I took him to see Zedd last year. Which was awesome.
Yeah.
And that's still like the one I'm waiting. I'm waiting for some electronic act to just follow up from Zedd. Because like I've seen Deadmau5, 2011. He was amazing. And then he was like one of the best. Cascade I saw in 2012. He was like right up there. Like they were both tied.
Yeah.
And then Zedd just blew both of them out of the water with how his show was. Because like the way his screen... And the way he throws in so many different genres of music is awesome. Like,
yeah.
He's really underrated as far as that goes. Like, I really wish...
Yeah, I mean, no, I totally agree with that because, like, the first thing I would think of is that he should be, like, a headliner, above the ones that are already... They're already starting. I mean...
And he's our age, too. Like, he's literally our age. Like, he's 24, I think.
Man. I don't feel so old anymore now.
Yeah.
Like, used to think, like, I'm 24, like, man, I'm getting old. I'm gonna start growing gray hairs now.
I think we got at least a good 20 years before we can really say we're old. I'm hoping so, but it sucks because I noticed everybody, all of us, like, all my friends on my friends list and, like, on the coffee runs, we're all getting older. But it doesn't really feel, like, it feels like it, but it doesn't feel like it, if that makes sense.
Yeah, no, I get you. Because, like... Well, the thing is that when we're on the coffee runs, you know, the thing will be like, yeah, we're here, we're enjoying ourselves, because we're actually having fun, we'll feel young.
And in cosplays, too.
Yeah, and that makes me feel even more young right there. See, yeah. this is going back to, like, even my high school days. Oh, God. Heaven forbid those happen again.
That's hilarious, though. Because, I mean, it's just, like, and it's cool because what will keep us younger are actually these videos, too. I mean, this is, think of it as, like, a reunion with, like... That's pretty much what it is. It's kind of like a mini high school reunion for me.
Yeah.
I'm actually seeing a lot of people that I've either known or have, you know, seen in high school or known of in high school and, you know, catching up with them. I mean, so that's pretty cool. Like, and these will always be there on YouTube.
Yeah. Yeah. And there you go. Like, there's the legacy left behind. This will be like opening up. This will be like the new wave version of like, oh, you want to see my yearbook? Nah, just go to YouTube, man. You'll see us there. There's your yearbook.
And I'm hoping to do that because, I mean, I know our high school reunion... Well, you graduated in 2008, right? Or when did you...
Yeah, high school is 2008, yeah.
Yeah, so, I mean, we all, like... Hopefully, by that time, there will be, like, dozens of coffee runs that have been made. And I'll even probably go on one with, like, more people from high school and, like, from the reunion or whatever. That'd be cool to do, like, a high school reunion coffee run, but that'll be, like... What, 4 years from now?
Yeah.
Man, that's crazy. Like, our reunion is 4 years away. That means that's when we'll really be old
man.
Fucks. That's going to be... Man, I can't believe that. But it doesn't matter because next year is going to be like the year of badassness anyway because there's going to be Halo 5 coming out and then there's going to be the Avengers 2 and all these other badass movies. And then finally, I'm just looking forward to next year mainly because like... I'm finally going to be able to go to, like, the big shows. Like, I'm planning on going to EDC maybe next year.
Oh, really?
In Vegas,
man.
Yeah. That and/or Electric Zoo in New York, because I've never been to New York. I really want to go.
I always get a lot of like updates from like my Snapchat about like
Electric Zoo. I know, got those too.
And I was like, man, every time I look, it's like,
oh, and it looks amazing because this
why
year,
you in New York, man.
And then, like, Electric, because that's really where it's at now, is Electric Zoo, Tomorrowland, World. Well, Tomorrowland's here, and that's amazing. Like, Electric Zoo, though, like, it was, like, all of it was, like, packed, like, hundreds of thousands of people. And that's crazy, because, I mean, and then my friend was telling me the lineup, he goes, dude, everybody was there, Cascade, Zed's Dead.
Oh, yeah.
Seven Lions, like, all the people that I've always wanted to see, because I've seen, like, a few of those already, but, like, all those and more, like, awesome, we can drive in here, I guess. But yeah, it's really fucking crazy, like, all the, like, the lineup, like, because they have really good lineups there, and I checked EDC, and, like, the lineups the past few years haven't been as big as, like, or as good as the ones, like, because, I mean, now at EDC, Headhunters, or Avicii, or the mainstream guys, nobody, or Martin Garrix, Animals, Levels, you know, like, it's just all of that, so yeah. I don't really... It's not something, like, I'd want to go, like, to see. Like, I mean, I wouldn't mind if it was Calvin Harris or something like that. Yeah. I wouldn't mind seeing that, but...
Yeah.
Well, that's why, this year I'm going to Something Wicked again. Because I went last year, and this year I'm excited to go even more because Cascade's going to be there.
Yeah, like, Cascade. Like,
so, I'm excited for that. I mean, Cascade, that's going to be awesome to see because that'll be the second time I'm going to see him. And Zed's Dead's going to be there. I've become a big fan of them this year. So they're gonna be there. A-Track, who else? Bass Nectar, who I want to see because I haven't seen yet, so that'll be cool having to see him for the first time. And then there's like quite a bit of Flostradamus, I think, is gonna be there.
Oh, okay,
too.
Yeah.
I think they are, yeah.
I'm trying to remember because when you're naming the artists, I'm picturing the poster of the actual,
yeah,
like,
or like the, how they look and stuff.
Yeah,
and I know probably once you see him, you recognize him. But since we're on the top, well, are there any shows you're gonna try to go to like this year or next year?
For right now, I'm just like, as much as I would like to, I'd rather just
kind of like save money.
Wait
first.
And save my money first, yeah. Because
that's the smartest thing to do too.
Yeah, and the thing is because before when I actually used to do that and go like I used to go to Stereo Live like. Very frequently, mm-hmm. And then like after about going for like 3-4 months, I realized, man, I just went through all my money.
Yeah,
and I was like, oh, I gotta slow down, you know.
But, yeah, that's why it's good to really. So that's what I'm gonna do. That's why I'm saving up now. I'm trying to save up now for like those big shows next year because I want to at least go to one or two. I mean, I really do want to go to like Tomorrowland or to Electric Zoo. Those two like are like the biggest ones so far. Like even bigger than EDC. Like they've grown a lot. Bigger, like massive in size, so
yeah,
that's really cool that they you know, it's getting out there. But yeah, I mean, yeah, that's the plans for next year. And then this year I'm gonna try and see if I can go to Lights All Night in Dallas, but I'm not sure yet, especially with that, you know, I haven't said it yet, but the Ebola thing,
yeah,
it's kind of been all over the news, so I don't really know how that's gonna go yet, because if it starts getting out of hand, I might not go to Dallas.
If you're gonna, if by the time you show up there, you might as well show up in your
in a mask, a hazmat suit or whatever.
No, you should show up in your Walking Dead, and right? Just like anyone who turns, I got
know.
You right here.
I'm like, dude, I'm telling you, dude, that's what I think is gonna happen. I think like that's the zombie apocalypse waiting to happen right there. I mean, there's no other way. It's gonna like just that's it. Like it's gonna happen. If it does happen, that's how it's gonna be. That's how zombies are gonna come.
Yeah.
And I'm just gonna have to get out my, you know. I'll just bust out a Rick costume or whatever.
Yeah.
The guy's walking.
And you're gonna hear the opening theme of The Walking
right?
Dead when you're just like
that'd be funny. Every time it just follows me everywhere I go. That'd be hilarious.
I don't know, if you actually had a theme song and it kept following you everywhere you went. I wonder if you would ever get bored of it at one point.
I think you'd probably go... I'd probably go insane if that happened. Mm. It'd have to be a damn good theme song, like Attack on Titans or something.
It has an epic, like...
Yeah.
Epic, like, theme to it, to where everywhere you go, it's like... It's annoying, but it's just so epic.
Yeah, so when you enter somewhere, you like... They know you're there. They know shit just got real.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, speaking of songs, I guess it's time to play the one that's been on your mind, and then I'll play the one that's been on my mind, because I've been raping my ears with music lately. They love it.
Yeah. Okay.
So do you want to? You can plug it in here. I think. Let me make sure the volume's. Oh, sorry.
All right. That was cool.
this song is?
This song is It Girl by Pharrell. And going along with the theme, because, well, the theme is in, the music video is an anime style, so I was like...
Oh, is it? Yeah. Like, they actually made a video of it?
Yes,
oh,
they made a video.
I didn't see
it. And it's like Pharrell on the beach, like, checking out all the girls, and he's like talking about that girl. He's got that graffiti style clothes, and he's gotta wear that hat, man.
The Smokey the Bear hat.
Yeah.
Smokey
the Bear.
But that's cool. Like, he is getting up there. I'm really glad he got to work with Daft Punk too. That was awesome.
Oh yeah.
So good, lucky.
Man, like, the fact that you actually have that says something a lot about the artist too. Is that if you have the flexibility to jump from different thing to different genre. Like, that says a lot right there. Exactly. That's talent, really.
Especially with Daft Punk. I mean, like, because Pharrell, pretty much, when you watch that video, and I watched the interview with him, and he's pretty much kind of, like, begged them to, like, let him work with them in a way.
Right.
And begged them, and he's like, yeah, I mean, I'll do whatever y'all need me to do. I'll play a tambourine if I have to. Yeah. That's what he said. And I was like, that's cool. And they made the right choice by working with him, because it was, that was, like, their hit right there. That was what got them noticed, like, a lot now.
Yeah.
And... Well, they've always been, like, big, but, I mean...
Oh, yeah, no, definitely, it's just...
But now, since that was, like, them kind of more mainstreamish song, I guess, like,
yeah.
It worked for them, and it was really... turned out really good.
Yeah, and it was a different approach for them, too. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, you typically have, like, your, you typically have, like, your... When you think of Daft Punk, you think of the original, like, Discovery, basically. You know?
Yeah. And then, like, that's their best... That's still their best album to me, is Discovery. I love that album.
Yeah. For others, it was like, I mean, whenever like they made the Tron,
I love the Tron soundtrack.
It was like, it was great.
Yeah.
The thing that people didn't have, like, I guess the one complaint though, but I mean, what do you expect? Was when they were describing on the album, like, the goal behind it was, orchestra, but with like minimalist electronic.
Yeah, it was like an electronic. What I really liked is that. When I found out they were gonna make the sequel to Tron, I immediately thought of how I wanted the soundtrack to sound like, and they nailed it perfectly, because I love the way they made that soundtrack, the way it sounded, that sound that they had, that do 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 do, like that was the Tron sound, and I love that sound because they did a perfect job with it. Like, and I really want them to make another Tron movie, because it's gonna take a while, but I want them to make another one. I want Daft Punk to come back and do it, because they did a perfect job. Like, it's really hard to do a score for a soundtrack for a movie.
Yeah.
It really is. Yeah. Like, and especially when you're a well-defined artist that already has their own thing. But with Daft Punk, they made it work, and that's when you know you've mastered the art of music in a way, kind of, or in some sort of form, because, I mean, for them to do that, like, for that soundtrack, that was awesome. They took their sound and still kept, you know, stayed true to their sound and still contributed very well to a great, like, to a movie like that. It made a damn good soundtrack. I love that.
And the thing too about it is that whenever you are making a score, basically, or you're trying to make any kind of music, you really have to, like, delve yourself into the project that you're working on. I'm pretty sure that Daft Punk had did plenty of, like,
research
on just Tron itself.
Yeah, aside
the music, like, just what is Tron?
Yeah,
and, like, just compose that into their own work.
Yeah, and I love that, because they did a damn, like, I mean, like I said, they did an amazing job with the way they, because when you're doing a score for a movie or for anything, you have to forget about what you like, and you have to worry about how the music is going to match the scene or the movie. If it's not going to match the scene or the movie, then it's going to be a disaster. That's why I love composers like Hans Zimmer and John Williams. Like, they do great jobs with their soundtracks to movies, like the Dark Knight soundtrack. like the score and then the Man of Steel score, like the soundtrack or whatever they did.
Yeah.
Really good job with that.
That would have been, you know.
But yeah, that's really, that's always been kind of like my little dream one day is to do a score, like,
score for something
like that. Like Destiny, the game, like,
oh,
the music,
yeah,
for that.
The music is great, love,
yeah,
man.
And it's awesome.
Amazing.
Because Martin O'Donnell, the same composer for the Halo soundtrack,
right,
he's there. I mean, it sucks because Bungie fired him right before the game, like,
yeah,
in May,
yeah,
and I was so mad. But I mean, it, you know, it happens. Yeah. They had their
little
spat or whatever. So, but yeah. I mean, I'm hoping
personal
now.
Issues.
I'm just hoping now he goes back to Halo since he's a free agent. I think now I'm hoping he does because that Halo 4 soundtrack wasn't as good. I don't know, it was okay, but because I buy all that soundtracks because I love the music. But
yeah, but that one was just like, eh.
Yeah, but I mean, I Martin O'Donnell, and he worked with Paul McCartney on a song for Destiny. It's in there. It's in the game. I just don't know
really?
Where. But I mean. Fucking Beatle, he worked with one. I'm like, that's freaking awesome. The fact that, that's when you know it's like, it's badass, and he's always done a great job. But it's time to play my song, and mine is from a group or artist that I like a lot that I got into just this year recently. They're called Odessa.
Okay.
And their new album just came out like I think last month or something or so. It's called Say My Name. It's really cool. And I'll be putting the links up too for our songs and everything. Oh, pardon. You can just chill here until the song ends.
Alright.
It's a really cool, like, their album's really good. They have a lot of cool. It's like taking a trip through Africa or something, like, the way some of their songs are.
Yeah.
But it's, they do a pretty good job with it. See, that's, I like their picture too. So,
oh.
That's all.
That was on Facebook, actually, right? You had a...
Yeah,
that...
Had
a, okay, I was like, when I saw it, I was like, okay.
Yeah, I was actually going to put a Netsky song on, too, because I've been having his music on my mind, too.
Oh, man.
Because I have his albums, but...
Like, he's like... He's the one that wakes me up every morning. Like, when when it plays, I'm out. I'm up. That's it.
Yeah, and he's got some good songs on his, like 911, that's a freaking...
Yeah.
Bass pumping song, and it sounds cool.
Crazy too. I mean, he's younger than us too.
I think so, right?
He's a little younger than us, and he started like, oof. You can correct me if I'm wrong later. I think it was around 14 years old, 16 years old, one of those two.
Yeah,
like,
I think
he started
did.
Really young.
Yeah.
And he's already so successful. And like,
that's crazy. And like, yeah, he started quite young, I think. Him and Zed.
Yeah.
And they're all classically trained, I think. Like, Zed, you know, he says every song he makes is on a piano first, and then he actually makes the song electronically, like, either in Pro Tools or whatever. So he's pretty... They're all smart, you know? Like,
yeah, they have that sense.
Yeah, like, I mean, all of them, Deadmau5, Cascade, Zed, Netsky, they all have some, you know, form of training classically or musically, and that's really cool. I mean... And Cascade finally sang on one of his songs, you know, Atmosphere
yeah.
last year. That was cool. I thought he did a good job with it, too. I mean, that's pretty cool that, you know...
That you would actually put the vocals in.
Yeah, because he said he was nervous about it. He goes, yeah, I knew when I did it that, you know, the fans were going to be like, whoa, dude. He goes, you should just stick to, you know...
Just stick what you know.
And then he goes, and then other fans were like, oh, dude, why didn't you do this before? You know, and it, I mean, this is a guy who's been in the scene for, like, years, like,
yeah.
since the late 90s. Or mid-90s even, and then finally, after all these years, like, to hear him sing on that song last year when I heard it, I was like, that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that was really, you know, that was awesome. And then now he's, like, out there, too. But, yeah, that's...
Man, this is crazy how much things have changed over time for that, man.
Yeah, I mean, and it sucks because it's a gift and a curse with the whole EDM, as the kids call it nowadays.
Yeah.
It's a gift, of course, because everybody's cherishing it and finally recognizing it for what it is and how good it can be, but... At the same time, then there's the fans that just go to the shows and just, you know, they just get drunk or wasted intentionally.
They lack the appreciation of what they went there for.
Especially the ones, and I can't stand it. Like, there's these kids that go out and, you know, they go on drugs, you know.
Yeah,
and they go just to enjoy. And I was like, if you need drugs to enjoy a show, if you need any form of drugs to enjoy music, that's really bad. Like,
yeah.
You've lost respect for me that way. Like, I mean, I can understand being on drugs sometimes, but, like, every time you go to show...
Every time you go to
show... Yeah, that's... You just don't have my respect, you know? It's just not right.
In my opinion, that's, like, putting on headphones to another song and then going to the concert. That's the way I, like, to me, that's the amount of disrespect it gives. But
that, and whenever I'll be at the very front row of a show and I'll see these kids next to me, they're either, and they'll just be texting or they'll be on their phones. I'm like, the show's up there. I'm like, why are you doing, like, why are you in the front?
If that were the case, I would have just been like, just throw their phone on the floor, man.
Yeah, it's stuff like that gets annoying sometimes. But I mean, you know, they're just, I guess they're kids. They don't know any better.
No, they don't know any better. But
still,
they really don't. they really don't.
Yeah, especially nowadays, North Shore and just things in general have gone downhill with that. Because I remember last year, they were saying we were like one of the top 10 most dangerous schools or whatever.
North Shore?
Something like that, yeah. Which is hard to, well, it's not hard to believe, but still. But yeah, that was Say My Name from Odessa, which I'm probably going to be playing more of their songs on these conferences. I'm addicted to this album right now.
Yeah.
I love
it.
It's
really
nice. There's some pretty good songs on this one. There's Confess, or what is it? Let me see. There's Bloom, which I like. That's the next one that was coming on. Then there's Sun Models. That's a good one. And there's is it Kusanagi? No, not that one. I think it's, oh yeah, Koto, that one's good. And then, where is it at? Oh, All We Need, that one's awesome. That's more like an R&B song, but it sounds cool. And then Memories That You Call. This album really, instantly was a good hit for me. I liked it a lot. But yeah, there's that. There's a lot of music I've been, like, listening to lately, which I have yet to play. Like, I still need to play that one that was on my mind the summer, the whole summer, which was from Little Dragon, Twice.
Yeah.
So I love that one. But the hell was that? Oh, I guess that was like a cop or whatever. I heard something go brrr.
I was like, that, I swear.
Oh, wait, no, I think I know what it was. I think it was my phone vibrating.
Oh, I was like, I swear that wasn't me.
That was funny. Yeah, it was.
Yeah, well, he's going to start rolling down the window now.
Right, be like, I didn't do it.
I didn't do it.
But yeah, well, I guess this pretty much wraps it up for this coffee run. I mean, this has definitely been a good one. It's been a long one because, I mean, we're at 42 minutes. So
yeah.
This will be plenty for the viewers, the fans, and everything to watch. And like I said, you're always invited back for another one, cosplay or not, you know.
Oh, yeah.
So, and that'd be cool. Hopefully we can hang out again sometime, you know, whenever. I know you've been busy with work, and the same here with me. Everybody knows I've been busy a lot.
Yeah.
I mean, well, with that car accident I got in last month, and then earlier this month, freaking lots of just crazy crap in school, of course, too, has been busy with midterms. But yeah, like I said, this is the first cosplay coffee run ever, and if anyone wants to do another one or wants to cosplay, you're more than welcome, because of course this is October, so
yeah,
you know, celebrate the month of
October.
Or like my philosophy teacher said, he goes, he says, yeah, Halloween's the perfect excuse for girls to dress up as sluts or something like that. Like, that's what I remember him saying. It's kind of true.
It's kind of true, yeah.
But it's funny, though. But yeah, I guess, since that's it, did you want to say anything? Do you have anything to say to your fans, friends, or foes, like I always say?
Oh, yeah. I'll thank you first, like, man. Just, like,
oh, yeah.
Appreciate you for even having me here. And, like, I'll definitely be back.
Yeah, anytime.
To my friends out there, you guys are awesome. You're badass. To my best friend. And
you can do shout outs if you want to, it doesn't matter.
All right.
Or if you know anybody that's a singer or that has a YouTube page, also, like I said, this is also to promote theirs.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Well, I don't know anybody on the YouTube scene right now. I'm just kind of like, I just scroll through those anyway. Mm-hmm. But I guess to my first Bane Thomas, you know, good luck with your, you know what. to my best friend Jessica, hey man, you know, this is for you. No.
That's cool.
To Thomas, I mean to Leo, to Jose, to Francisco, Flavio, you guys are my brothers, man, you know, so we'll definitely hang out. Maybe we'll do this too. I mean,
cool.
If we ever do like any more coffee runs, pretty soon you're gonna have like a bus instead of a car, you know, start taking all these people with you.
Well, the plan is for next year to have also, I announced it like back in the summer, Coffee Run the Motion Picture, which is pretty much
In a world where
coffee exists every day. One man, 50 guests. No, well, my plan is to have at least as many guests as... I'm going to set aside one full day. It's going to be on a Saturday, hopefully. And I want to have as many coffee room guests as I can. Like, I'm going to have this filled with three people back there, one over here, two people back there, one over here. And I just... I time it and we do like half an hour here and I go to the next point in the city and pick up somebody. Oh, okay. And they go on like a big ass coffee run marathon and I'm gonna combine it into one big ass movie so people can follow me throughout the entire day of my life of just getting, you know, meeting up with these people, whether it's getting coffee or whatever. And it'll be called Coffee Run the Motion Picture, and it'll be the biggest coffee run and the longest coffee run and the most guest filled coffee run ever. So that's, and I want as many people to be a part of that too. So if anybody's watched all the ways up to this 45 minutes, then you'll know.
Right.
But yeah, I guess this is it then. We'll end it here and then, yeah, see you guys next time. Deuces. Thanks for joining me too.
Sure thing, man.